Hey again everyone, today I'm going to be taking a look at the TTS Generation Web UI. This is a front-end for multiple text-to-audio and voice cloning deep learning models that aims to simplify the work of generating and post-processing audio samples. The front-end uses a Gradio interface which is probably familiar to users of the Auto 1111 Stable Diffusion Web UI. And the authors are working on a React-based interface with some new features such as the generation and processing pipeline. I'm not going to be going into detail about the models themselves here, rather I'm going to try to stick to using the TTS Generation Web UI as intended and try to give an overview of using the models for practical applications. I've played with most of the features individually as they were released, but having things available in one package may open up some new possibilities, and many of the models have had tremendous performance gains since release. If you want to try out the TTS Generation Web UI, you can run it on your local machine or through cloud computing services like Google Colab. There's a Colab-ready Jupyter notebook linked on the project's GitHub page if you want to go that route, but I won't be going over Colab here. I can't really afford Colab Pro right now, and I find the free service unstable at best. According to the authors, the WebUI should work on Windows, WSL, and Linux-based OSs with support for NVIDIA CUDA-based GPUs, AMD GPUs, and CPU support. I'll be testing things out on a system running Windows 10 with a 12GB NVIDIA RTX 3060 and a Ryzen 5600G CPU. The WebUI can be installed manually, but if you decide to go with a manual installation, you'll probably need to open up the install script and try to follow the up-to-date requirements rather than following what's on the GitHub page. Thankfully, the project came with a one-click installer. Normally, I load these because trying to trace a problematic package or bug is a nightmare. But currently the auto install works well, so I definitely recommend that method here. The front end installs a ton of packages and requirements. I think the base is about 20GB without models, so it's a bit of a headache doing it by hand. For the auto install, download the installer and extract the zip to where you'd like the installation stored. The installed UI will end up in a subdirectory of the installer called TTS Generation Web UI. Run the start Windows batch file and the installer will download and install Miniconda and set up its own conda environment. Once the installer is done, it will load automatically and probably pop up a couple Windows Defender network permission boxes. Let's take a look at SinoAI's Bark. Before jumping into generation, take a look at the settings page to configure the proper model types. Many of the models have small and large variants. The authors suggest the large models for those with more than 10GB of VRAM, and small models for those with less than 10GB of VRAM. For the most basic usage, just enter some text as the prompt and generate using default settings. Text prompts can include annotations in square brackets to indicate common sounds, speech effects, or vocal sounds. Entering shouts, shouting, whispers, or whispering can sometimes guide speech to sounding louder or quieter. Using laughter, laughs, sighs, or gasps can also sometimes elicit vocal sounds. A list of some common annotations is available on the SinoAI Bark GitHub page. Using music or using a music note Unicode character can often output something resembling music, but it's probably not going to be of very high quality. The burn-in prompt is unspoken text used to bias the output of the model. I've tried not to cherry-pick the examples used in this video. You may notice defects or sometimes that the speech sounds like it's been generated with ambient background music.
Text prompts can include annotations in square brackets to indicate common sounds, speech effects, or vocal sounds.
Text prompts can include annotations in square brackets to indicate common sounds, speech effects, or vocal sounds.
The Audio Web UI integrates Facebook's Demucs or separation models, which can be used in your workflow to try to remove some of that.
Text prompts can include annotations in square brackets to indicate common sounds, speech effects, or vocal sounds.
Vocos is another method that can be used to remove noise. Send the generated sample NVZ to Vocos and reconstruct it by hitting decode.
Text prompts can include annotations. Text prompts can include annotations in square brackets to indicate common sounds, speech effects, or vocal sounds.
You can then send that to Demucs again afterward for further processing.
Text prompts can include annotations in square brackets to indicate common sounds, speech effects, or vocal sounds.
You can use a previously generated sample to generate new speech in the same voice. It doesn't always sound exactly alike, but it often does a reasonable job.
You can use a previously generated sample to generate new speech in the same voice.
Bark can clone a voice using only a few seconds of audio, though I find this process is sensitive to the sample input. The Bark voice cloning tab has support for a few languages, but I'll be focusing on English here. To generate a voice clone, open up the tab and select a tokenizer. I've tried the various Hubert models and didn't notice too much of a difference between them. And then provide an audio sample.
When I actually hit the age that people were in reality bites, I was a little shocked because they always seemed so much older and cooler than me.
Keep note of the file name generated because after you've used the WebUI for a while, the list can become a little cluttered. You may need to try a few different audio clips to get a desirable outcome if you're providing your own audio samples. And editing out long portions of silence seems to improve the output.
When I actually hit the age that people were in reality bites, I was a little shocked because they always seemed so much older and cooler than me.
There are two selection boxes on the generation page. The audio voice can be from a prior Bark generation or can be generated on the Bark voice clone tab. The list is auto-populated by the WebUI with the latest voices generated. Click the refresh button next to the list if you don't see your files. The semantic voice can help guide the pacing and tone of the speech output, but this can sometimes create worse sounding speech, so the semantic voice sample is optional.
You know, these words were never spoken.
RVC, or Retrieval-Based Voice Conversion, is a speech augmentation model that replaces the vocals in a track with those generated by the model. RVC models can't be trained with this UI, but there are hundreds of quality pre-trained models available online. I'll link to a couple sites that have some pre-trained RVC models, mostly of celebrity voices. Download the models and extract them to the Data, Models, RVC, Models directory. Then select the model to use from the dropdowns on the RVC models list. If you don't see your model listed, click the refresh button to rescan the directory.
This is some funny stuff. I think I'm gonna rent this too. I'm getting a little bit greedy. I'm sorry, MTV.
There are two major versions of RVC, 1 and 2, and so far I've only had RVC version 1 models work with the WebUI. RVC 2 models just seem to hang after loading, but you might have better luck.
We have live in Manali. I mean, Ben Vereen is in this. What other gum can you have? Drama, comedy, dancing, music, everything, all of it. Wheel en Rouge, it's the only film of modern day to sort of capture wit.
In addition to speech generation, the TTS WebUI has support for general-purpose diffusion-based audio generation models. Under the MusicGen and AudioGen tab, you'll find Facebook's AudioGen and MusicGen models. For vocals and sound effects, I find the larger AudioGen and MusicGen models work best, and for attempts to generate music, the MusicGen melody model works best. However, best is doing a lot of heavy lifting here. None of these really work well. They're fascinating, but much of the output is confused and noisy. The recent demos of Suno AI's chirp model are far and beyond what you can do here, but you may find these useful for generating ambient sound, sound effects, or musical inspiration. Magnet is another general-purpose audio generation model family by Facebook, supported by the UI through AudioCraft. You're limited by length here, but you may find that the Magnet models are a little faster than the other ones. Again, I'm not really going to spend any time going over the options here. I feel like the output is often like dumping a jigsaw puzzle onto a table and expecting a beautiful picture. The fidelity is there, but there's a lot of noise in the output, and very little of it makes any sense. Often the output will only resemble music for a few seconds before sounding like a Casio keyboard being thrown down some stairs. Frankly, I'm not quite sure what the purpose of this model family is, or if this is even working correctly, because I've never been able to get anything useful from the Magnet models.
Tortoise TTS is also supported by this UI, however, at the moment, it's a little limited.
Custom-trained models are failing to load because it appears some variable is mistakenly hard-coded.
And while I think the authors have integrated some of the Tortoise speed improvements with this implementation, something isn't working correctly on my system.
This version of Tortoise is running about as slow as the original did, taking about 3 minutes to produce a single sentence. Far too slow to be any use for me.
And it also appears to have some sort of leakage where every subsequent generation takes longer and longer.
Custom voices can be used as long as they were generated against the original Tortoise model, but there doesn't appear to be any voice cloning support here either. Because of the other bugs and limitations, I'll skip past looking at Tortoise anywhere here and revisit it later if support improves or if this WebUI adds any training support.
If you're interested in training custom Tortoise models or custom voices, I still recommend trying out the MRQ AI voice cloning project. If you go that route, I have a handful of videos on training Tortoise models on the channel.
The WebUI also has some basic integration for Facebook's massively multilingual and multimodal machine translation model, or seamless M4T. This is a model that does speech recognition, translation, speech-to-speech, speech-to-text, and text-to-speech. It's a real jack-of-all-trades.
ผมจะไม่พูดถึงการแปลเสียงแบบ seamless เพราะผมเป็นคนพูดภาษาเดียวผมไม่สามารถประเมินคุณภาพของการแปลได
้ Unfortunately, I'm mostly monolingual, so I can't really comment on the accuracy of the translations. However, the sound quality of the output and the speed are really impressive. Once the model's loaded, after a few generations, it seems like it's almost real-time.
Je vais éviter de parler de la traduction vocale sans couture, parce que je suis principalement monolingue, je ne serai pas en mesure d'évaluer la qualité des traductions.
That's about all I want to go over in this one. Just a broad overview of the TTS Generation Web UI project, and a quick look at what works and what isn't quite working, and what could be useful for your creative projects. If there's something you'd like me to cover in more detail, leave me a note down in the comments. That's all for now, thanks for watching.